Good morning, traders. Matt Weller here, Global Head of Research with Forex.com. Today is Monday, the 9th of September, 2024, and I'm about to go over the key things you need to know ahead of today's U.S. trading session. Now, overall, volatility is pretty subdued. We do see a bit of a bounce back from some of the big moves we saw last week. Just looking at the U.S. dollar, it's gaining ground against all of its major rivals. We also see U.S. indices bouncing back about 0.5% after a big swoon last week. So we're getting a bit of a counter trend move after the weekend, after nerves have had time to settle. That said, some of the concerns of last week still remain with us. We're going to be watching the economic calendar very closely, jumping down to this last bullet here. The key things to watch this week will be the U.S. CPI report on Wednesday, followed by the European Central Bank on Thursday. No surprises expected from the ECB, but the economic outlook for that central bank will be absolutely essential to watch, even if that 25 basis point rate cut is as close to a done deal as we can get in markets. The one spot I did want to double click on in this morning's video is China. The world's second largest economy continues to see really weak economic data. The CPI number came in at 0.6% year over year. And on the producer side, inflation is actually deflation. Prices have fallen by nearly 2% on a year over year basis. Looking ahead, out of China, we'll get the retail sales and industrial production data on Friday, but it's starting to look like we might need some sort of stimulus from Chinese authorities or the People's Bank of China to stoke animal spirits again and get traders more optimistic. Back on Thursday, I highlighted dollar yen as my chart of the day. We're going to go back to that well because it's at an interesting spot as we speak. This is mislabeled. Chart. It's actually a 4-hour chart, allows us to see a little bit more detail on the relevant levels to watch early in this week, and that is support down at 142. That was the low that we saw back in early August, as well as resistance, which is the level of previous support at 144. Those are the two levels I'll be watching certainly through the early part of this week and perhaps through the rest of this week on dollar yen, with a neutral bias within that region. Certainly for shorter term traders, there may be opportunities to set up scalp trades within there. But depending on how we break between 142 and 144, that could set the tune for the next 200 pip move here in dollar yen. So those are the levels to watch there. That is today's video. Thank you for carving some time out of your day to watch. And regardless of whether you're catching us on Twitter or YouTube, please do like this video, subscribe to our channel, and give me a follow. It's a great free way to show your support, help us with the algorithms, and get more eyeballs on our content. Thanks, and best of luck with your trading this week.